talking about this happening.
Bill Graham, motor up in San Francisco, about just showing up at lunchtime in this Embarcadero plaza. And so they backed in this flatbed truck and threw all their gear on it and, you know, set up a PA real quick one in the morning and literally just walked in and did an hour long free show. Forty, 50,000 people just jammed this plaza. It was, to me, one of the most satisfying things when we actually shot it. And we actually, like, even rented a helicopter for the day to get a couple aerial shots. And it felt, almost felt like a real movie for a second there. And ended up getting this sequence, you know, that's in the film all along the Watchtower.
Just as a sort of private joke we were playing on ourselves, we were calling it the Save the Yuppie Concert because it was in the business district. And I was getting carried away on this, and I thought, you know, a spray can. There were so many dark and ugly things stop the traffic in our cities, and I wanted something light and beautiful stop the traffic, and that's what it our concert was, and I just wrote.
The call was, you know, you two want you to sing with them, and can you set up a rehearsal? And we set up the rehearsal. They said, you know, pick an out of the way place. And I said, well, we'll do it up in Harlem. In the church that, you know, is one of our choir members' church, and I know the place, and I think it'll be a good place to do it.
I saw all the lights and cameras. I said, gee, this is bigger than what I thought it was. I said, gee, we're really going to do this.
When they walked into church, it was like, they're here.
We felt really good about that, that they came to see us and to film with us here in a church.
But they're into the idea that black music is like the foundation of rock, and is a very important element of rock and roll.
They came in and they listened to our arrangement once, and then we listened to the way they play once, and the next thing you know, everyone's singing.
Oh,
ambition is to boldly go where no rock and roll group has ever gone before and, you know, deafen the solar system and, you know,
save
search out old soul records and steal their spirit. We intend to make records until people are entirely sick of YouTube.
You know, with our touring commitments up until now, it's been literally a scramble to get a record finished, and then we're on the road, and then it's like 9 months before we go back to the studio again. This time, I think we'll be in the studio probably before Christmas.
One of the great things about being this successful is we don't have to worry about being successful. We just can do what we want to do.
YouTube's on fire at the moment about the music. And we're not set, you know, to become yuppies now and buy a motorboat and go sailing. And it's not in our blood. It's our music that makes the difference.
We don't know exactly where we're going, but when we do, we'll let you know.
Can't we get it? Somebody who would just follow us around and just try to capture the moment, which is what we try and do in our music.
What I think we've tried to do is execute that concert footage in a way that's a little bit different. It'll always be four guys on stage playing rock and roll, but what we've tried to do through the camera placement, by putting a lot of our cameras on stage and very close to the stage, we've tried to get inside the show, from a point of view that hasn't been explored as often. I always felt that U2's music was very cinematic, that because there's a kind of an intensity. It's very cinematic. There's a drive to it. There's content. There's drama, and you know, it's about something.